Welcome to Norfolk Perspectives on Location. I'm Bob Batch, and I'm downtown right in front of the Governor's School for the Arts. I can't wait to go in because to see these kids hard at work pursuing their passion, and I'm going to see if maybe I can join them on that passion and become a successful Governor's School student myself.
We are in Governor's School Black Box. It is a black box. It is our theater, and it's right in the middle of transition from one performance that we had over the weekend, now getting ready for the theater performance. So it's a black box.
What is your normal day?
When I get here, it's looking at budget, it's signing off on contracts, it's preparing for whatever is next. And then it's talking to parents. And then when the kids get here, it's whatever happens.
The concept of Governor's School, how does it work?
There are 19 Governor's Schools across the state. Okay. And you know, this was the years ago way to support gifted students and provide them with other services outside of their normal high school. So out of the 19, this one is the only one that totally focuses on the arts. Everybody else, maybe math and science, or maybe arts, math and science, maybe politics or something else. But we totally focus on the arts. 6 different departments: dance, instrumental music, musical theater, visual arts, vocal music.
So all right downtown Norfolk, which means when you're out to lunch, there's all kinds of energy I've discovered.
Yeah.
How did that happen?
The city, the mayor, you know, Governor's School has been in Norfolk for a long time. The city of Norfolk really supported what we do and they wanted us to stay. So they allowed us to, and they helped us renovate this space so that we could exist right here on Granby Street, part of the arts district, an extension.
That's right. Now, the kids are coming from which school districts then?
All the way from Franklin. Franklin to here. Franklin, Southampton, Suffolk, Isle of Wight, Chesapeake, Portsmouth, Norfolk, Virginia Beach. We have 8 school districts.
Wow. Now, those kids come from those schools in school buses. I was standing outside when they were kind of all gathering.
Yeah.
School buses, moms and dads.
Dads, school buses, some of them drive. Okay. They even drive.
Now, how does a kid get into the program?
They have to audition.
Okay.
So in December, Deborah, who is the assistant director, and I will go to the various school districts and do what we call a GSA night. And that's for any student that's interested in learning more about the Governor's School, hearing about the Governor's School. And we take students with us because our students tell the story better than we could ever tell the story. And they have so many, you know, it's almost like, I don't know, maybe some people feel like we feed them Kool-Aid, you know, but they tell this amazing story and make students really intrigued about knowing more about this program. And we audition them in January. And then in March, we make some selections and send those letters, and our new students are waiting to find out if they made it, and we have a golden ticket. And so every student who makes it gets this golden ticket, but the golden ticket is really for the parent. But anyway, they get excited about this golden ticket because that means that they've been accepted into the program. It's not only a commitment for the student, but it's a commitment for the parent too. Because, you know, these students are here every day for 3 hours, but actually they spend more than 3 hours here. So we have late rehearsal and parents have to be responsible for coming to picking up their kids. So these kids are here from 1, sometimes until 10 o'clock at night.
Now, what's the first clue that you might have that a kid is ready for coming to Governor's School?
You know, I think is whatever the kid is, the student is interested in.
So as a parent, to kind of be plugged in where their passion might be.
Yeah, I mean, you just kind of watch what your kid does and just help them to grow that art form. For a visual arts student, a visual artist who draws, someone who draws all the time or always trying to create art, you know, and you just want to help that kid just grow that passion.
Okay, let's talk about the kid that's got the passion, got the creativity, but high school is just not their thing.
We have a lot of those in this building.
And for a lot of our students, I think Governor's School helps them get through their high school, you know, because they're waiting, watching that clock to see when it's time to leave for governor's school. But they have to go through high school in order to get their, they don't get a diploma from me.
What about that parent that is focused on the three R's? And
they should be.
Okay.
I think they should, but I think the arts enhance that. We have a lot of kids that are taking AP, whatever. I have a lot of instrumental music students that are going into engineering and are planning to be doctors or other avenue in their career, but there is a correlation between science and music. I believe that, and I see that, and our kids are strong in math. We have we have artists or alum that are on the production side, that are on the technical side. We have students who are engineers but are still gigging on the side in music. We have photographers. We have entrepreneurs that are visual artists who are selling their artwork.
Now, you brought up the business side of the arts.
Right.
Do they dabble in that?
We try, because they are independent contractors. That's what they end up, regardless of what you do, you are an independent contractor. My hope is that we do a little bit more with that, because I think even colleges fall short in really explaining that business side. But we hope that my visual arts students, when they leave here, they can go on and start their work when they leave us, because they know how to set up an art exhibit. They know how to, you know, price their work, because that's what we teach them.
I have very little talent, so I want to venture through the school and see how little talent I might have.
All right.
So where should we start, and kind of walk me through where we should go?
You know what? Let's start up and then go down.
That's probably the best place to go. So what's up?
Instrumental music is first. Start there. Maybe, you know, if our technical kids are in the shop, maybe we get you to hammer a nail or sew a costume or something.
So that's art?
Yeah, that's art.
Because you got to build the theater.
You have to build the props, the set, all the costumes. We have to build costumes.
Okay. So you got the costume and you got the set design.
Right.
You mentioned instrumental, so
we have instrumental upstairs. At this time, they're probably in theory. So we can put you in a theory class and see how you do. How are you with music and...
I can't count.
But I know what that little thing means.
What's that little thing?
A little tail on it.
Okay, we'll work on that one.
We'll explore that. Okay, so you have music theory.
Right.
Because again, it's a matter of learning through it rather than just picking up an instrument and knowing how to blow it.
Right.
Well, you have to know how to blow it before you get in here.
Okay.
And know something.
And so, because it does start with audition. So you have more than just a bass talent.
Right.
Okay.
You do.
So singing?
Singing, we can put you in a singing. We have auditions today. That's what we need you to do. Our musical theater department's doing Smokey Joe's. They're doing auditions today. How would you like to be a part of that?
That could be interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, it could be
I'd like to see you do that.
Okay. So dance?
Dance, yes.
That's what's across the street,
That's across the street. We have dance here too, but it's different. We have the dance department across the street. Musical theater students will tap, jazz, ballet, you know, but they do a little bit of everything.
You have to know how to count.
Yeah, you do.
Okay.
At least to 8.
8?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm used to counting to 10, so we'd be okay. Okay, so what about, you mentioned the visual arts.
Yes. Now that's where you're going to have fun, because we have pottery. Today is ceramics. So we're going to put you on a potter's wheel.
You ready to venture through and see if it happens? Let's go for it.
Okay,
cool.
I have a new student, and he wants to learn how to conduct.
Let's go.
Okay,
all
cool.
Right.
What are we
go for it.
So, okay, I just follow you.
Start by snapping.
Why aren't they playing?
Oh, you're perfect. You're perfect. You've seen it.
So how do you get him to play?
Authority. The grade.
The grade. Okay, you all have A's today.
Yeah, it's awful fast.
And you need to go in like this. No, not like this.
Can I hurt it?
Yeah.
Oh, I can?
And then take your hand up here and try to fry chop it. One more. No. Slowly, like, add pressure to it.
Hey, this is actually doing something.
That really is not bad.
What do you think,
I'm impressed.
How's my audition?
Doing pretty well.
Is it?
Yeah, but watch what you're doing. Sorry, Bradley. I'm sorry. Dr. Cook, I am so sorry. But I have a new student who wants, he's doing an audition for musical theater. So do you have a minute to coach him a little bit? Thank you, Bradley. I appreciate it. You are so awesome.
These guys all auditioned to get in here, right?
Yes, and most of them sang for Mio Bend, right? Bend. So.
Carl Mio Bend?
And Bend.
What'd they say? Steve, what this?
No, not the English.
Oh, come on.
I'm sorry, it's Italian.
But it's got English written there. Credi mi amore. Have you ever heard of lip sync?
Welcome to the apartment.
Yay! What?
You're in.
Okay, excuse me, Jeff. Can I interrupt for a minute? Before Bob goes into his audition for musical theater, can we get some rhythm in here? Can he join you guys?
It works pretty good, then I'll take it.
I was gonna say, this is like being on Dancing with the Stars with no rhythm. Only two? How did I do?
You did great.
Todd, excuse me. Bob really wants to audition for dance, so can he audition?
That's really Todd?
Come on in, we got a spot right here.
Give me something easy.
We're gonna take two demi-plies and a straight and demi, then the arms to second. Two demis and a straight, two demis and a straight, arms to a beat, two demis and a straight, and demi, and straight, go to releve, which is up on your toes, Bob, and then you'll plie. You'll shift and go to second.
Yes.
Yeah.
We're done?
No, we're not done. You haven't even done the combo yet. We're just teaching it to you. So you have to memorize the combo, Bob, and then we perform it. Standing tall, arms in front, lift the bellies, lift, lift, one, lift, lift, two, arms to second, three, up, up, four, lift your center, Bob, to the V, lift. Lift plie, lift, lift releve, and plie, turn out to first, plie, lift, lift, plie, lift, lift, doing good, Bob, arms, and lift, lift to the feet, match the shape of their arms, plie, lift, lift releve, lift your core up high, plie, legs wide, 2 seconds, and one, two, three, and two, lift, lift to the feet. Lift, lift,
tummy in.
I'm done. He's like, I'm done.
Whoa.
We did nothing.
You did nothing?
That was very little.
Really?
Yeah, very little.
But I'm tired.
I know. That can happen. That's why we're dancing. It takes 10 years to build a dance.
To get over it?
Yeah, to get over it, too, if you start at our age.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Okay, I think I'm going back to the ball.
Love me tender, love me.
I was told I can bounce the ball real good.
Really? Would you do all the singing?
Well, how did I do?
Well, Bob, I think maybe we better go with the elevator instead of one of our artists. Maybe this is what you need to do. So why don't you head up to the sixth floor?
Okay, I'll just hit the button.
Yeah, just hit the button.
You know what? It's been a great time at Governor's School for the Art. The kids work hard. They pursue their passion. There's great magic that occurs here. And obviously, I found my role. Six?
Number six.
Bye.